respect to creation and insertion. Before we begin, I just want to ask you all whether you are all ready with your creation and insertion of data in the tables and all that. So that if you are ready with your tables, then we can go ahead with the queries directly. Raman, you are sharing, is it?
Ma'am, as you say, if you will disturb the class, then I will ask you later.
All right. See, at the end of the class also, you others, other students, you, at the end of the lab session also, you all can, you know, I'll be online, so you can check with me, share your screen, perhaps if you have some doubts, or you can even send a screenshot of your error to me on WhatsApp. I'll be able to help you out, because unless you ask me or you let me know what is the error at your end, I'll not be able to correct you, no? So whenever you are trying, if you are getting any errors, please do let me know, so that it will be easy for me also. Rupak, you are done with your insertion and creation and insertion of data?
Yes, ma'am.
No error, no problem?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Varsha?
Yes, ma'am, I'm done.
All right. Veena? Are you finished with your creation and insertion, Veena?
No, ma'am.
Why?
It's not opening, ma'am. The software is.
Then to whom did you inform about it? Did you check with Shashi, sir?
No, ma'am.
Then what are you doing? Simply keep the
error. I told my
answer. You simply keep the error means what? 2 weeks over that we have shared the software with you, and still you people are not ready with your systems, and you know software installation is not finalized at your end. Creation, insertion, first exercise is already over. Today's lab will be finishing with the first exercise. Second exercise will be starting next week. Still you are all not done means then what I should tell? 2 weeks time is over. Still you are all not getting it right at your end. It's very bad. Keep saying some reason or the other, then how do we know? Which Windows username, Rupak? I don't know. Windows we are not using, no?
I'm the virtual machines.
Yeah, MCA01, MCA01. It will end up in me teaching, going on teaching, but you not learning or getting the concepts. If you don't have it at your end, it will become easier, difficult for you all to catch up. That's the reason I'm telling that you should keep it ready at your end.
Ma'am, I am getting the error that not connected to Oracle every time.
Not connected to Oracle. But last time you were connected, no? And you were able to do, right? Some errors we sorted out.
In the branch section, ma'am, I am able to enter the values. But I'm the student, when I'm entering it, it is showing not connected to Oracle.
Who else is still not ready with creation and insertion of data? Can I know from you all, anybody else who is still not ready with your setup at your end? Before I begin, because that is more important than, so I can go on doing, that is not an issue for me. But how much of you are getting it at your end is more important for me. And all your exams will be held offline only for sure. So without, don't take this lightly, learning online. Anusha, things are fine at your end? The installation, creation, insertion is over?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Done.
Yeah. Good. Bhargav, what about you?
Done, ma'am.
Why not?
Done, ma'am.
Done or no? I didn't hear you. Sorry.
Done, done, ma'am.
Okay, fine. What about you, Huma?
Yeah, ma'am, done, ma'am.
I'll ask you to share your screen and you should do it. Simply, you cannot not try to say something and push off. Santosh, are you there?
Ma'am?
Santosh? Charan? Charan? Rashmi, are you done with your installation, creation, insertion and all?
Yes, ma'am, I'm done with it. But in the lab section, I can't use my laptop, ma'am. My mom is using it. Every day in the afternoon, my mom has to use my laptop. So I can't do it, no, ma'am. I'll do it in the evening sessions, ma'am. After my mom gets free, I inserted all the way.
Okay, fine. Okay, so let us begin with our, so in the last lab session we have done, with the ER diagram, the schema diagram for this first exercise, and then we have also seen how we can create tables, and we have also inserted some data for all these tables. Now, I told you one important thing is, first before you, though I have given the data for you all to enter, and I hope all of you have entered the same data that I have given you all. The most important thing when you are trying to enter the data is, please look into the set of queries that you have to answer whenever you want to enter the data into that database, because whatever query is asked, you should be able to retrieve some records at least pertaining to that particular query. You cannot always say no, if your query may be right, but there may not be any matching records in your database. In that case, it will show as records not found. In the examination, you cannot show such answers, responses like no records found. You cannot show that. You have to show some couple of records when the query is executed. Everyone will expect some records to be shown pertaining to that particular query. Now, based on that only, you should do your data entry. Don't blindly simply enter some data into your database tables, and then you will not we will not be able to find out in that case whether your query itself is wrong or you don't have any data at all in the database. That is what will happen. So don't give such chances. All right. Now, look into your first letters. I hope all of you have a copy of your syllabus with you. Do you have or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Please have a copy, soft copy. It has been shared, I think, with all of you already, the syllabus. keep the copy of the lab syllabus with you, because otherwise it is very difficult for us to again go through, or I'll have to keep sharing between the screens, and that becomes difficult for me. So we have a total of 8 queries as far as this exercise is concerned. So here, if you see here, the first query is list the details of students who are studying in second semester MCA. So this indicates that when you enter the data, you have to enter some records which are pertaining to semester as second semester. You have to enter a course, you have to enter as, or branch, you have to enter as MCA. Okay, if you observe in our data that we have entered, we have given some data which is second semester, some students who are in second semester, and some course which is branch which is MCA is also there. And then list the students who have not borrowed any books. This also, while you enter the data into the database, you have to take care that some students have not borrowed any books, so that you will be able to retrieve those records. Because otherwise it will become difficult. You cannot show, as I told you again and again, you cannot show no records found. Okay, then display who second semester, third query, if you observe, it is second semester MCA students who have borrowed books. So again, you should make sure that there are some second semester MCA students who have borrowed books. Your data entry should be like that. And then look at the fourth query, display the number of books written by each author. So make sure that at least I know you have 2 books corresponding to a particular author. Otherwise, you cannot show this particular record. You have to have at least 2 books which are written by an author, so that you can display the how many books each author has written. Even if it is 1, it is fine. But every author you cannot have just 1. You may have to have 2. Okay, and then see this. Fifth query is display the student details who borrowed more than 2 books. So you have to take care of this also. When you are entering the data, you have to ensure that the same student is borrowing at more than 2 books. That means at least 3 books, one particular student, you should have entered data. Then display the student details who borrowed books of more than 1 author. All this you have to take care when you are trying to enter the data. List the of course, book names in descending order, that's okay. Then the last is list the details of students who borrowed books which are all published by the same publisher. So you should also ensure that the same publisher books a student has borrowed. This many things you have to take care while you enter the data. With all this in mind only, I have given that set of data. It is not with simply with some kind of mechanically I have entered that data. No. I have taken a lot of care to see that every query you are going to get some result for that. That's how the data is entered. Are you able to see my Oracle screen?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Let us take the simplest of the queries. Which do you think is the simplest query of the 8?
First one, ma'am.
No?
First one.
Okay. Go to the 7th query. What is the 7th query? That's the easiest here. Display the book names in descending order of their names. That's all you have to do. Display the book names in descending order of their names. Where? Now, any query that you have to answer, you should analyze which are the tables that you have to access for this, for answering this particular query. Can you tell me which are the tables that you will have to access in order to answer this particular query?
Book table.
Yeah. Table. Yes. Is it only book? Yeah. Because we have to tell about the book names. We have to sort the book names. Let us see what we have in our book table first. Let me give select star from book. Okay. These are the books that I have. We have operating system, data structures, COC, DBMS, DE, that is your digital electronics. I have given it as DE. And then you have C++. So I have to now sort this particular book names in descending order. what keyword I should use if I have to do the sorting? Anyone? We have discussed in the last two lab sessions during the basic
order by ascending. Order by ascending or descending. Order by descending.
Correct. Yes, very good. So here you have to write order by. Order by is a keyword which is used for sorting the records based on a particular key, whatever you are using. Now suppose you don't give anything, by default it is going to sort in ascending order. But since you want to sort it in descending order, we have to give it as DSC. So how do I give? Now select, this is the simplest query among the eight. Select star from book. That is select star from your table name. Table name is book. Order by. You have to use this keyword order by whenever you want to sort. What they have asked, display the book names in descending order. So I have to sort it by, sort it in the based on the book name. So order by book name in descending order. If I leave it like this, I will just show you. If I leave it like this, order by book name, by default it will sort it in ascending order. Look at that. C, C++, C, O, DBMS, DE, data structures, OS. This is ascending order by default. We don't want ascending order, correct? We have to sort it in descending order. So by book name you have to give DESC. So see here, first is OS, then comes data structures, then digital electronics, DBMS, CO, C++, and C. So it is sorted in descending order. That is your result of your seventh query. Are you all doing along with me? At least those who have things fine at your end.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
If you all got the result, please put it in the chat window so that I can proceed further. And I also told you the other day, all of you, please maintain a written, handwritten copy of whatever you are doing. You are handwritten or you want to type it, it is up to you. But ER diagram, your schema diagram, the creation that we did, the insertion that we did, the data that we have entered, and today's queries, all this, your observation should be properly written and a copy should be at your end. Okay, we will be discussing whatever we are discussing here, and for the lab, that's all. I will not be sharing any extra material for this. Whatever material I'll be giving is only for theory, not anymore for your lab, because we are already spending so much of time. So it is your responsibility to write it down at your end. Am I clear to you all? Do please do write down, because otherwise it will become difficult for you. The basic commands, of course, I have shared a copy with all of you, so that is already ready with you all. From the first lab exercise onwards, please maintain a copy at your end. Either you write in sheets or you write in your book. It's up to you. How do you maintain it? Or you want to type it, it's all up to you. But whatever has to go into your record, that has to be maintained properly at your end. Don't come back to me when the college opens. Don't come back to me saying, ma'am, I don't have anything with me, but I attended all the labs. Sorry. That we cannot agree. Okay, I think all of you got, most of you have got this answer. This query, right? So let us proceed. Okay, let me go to the first query now. So what is the first query? List the details of students who are all studying in second semester MCA. Now, what I want you to do is, can you look into your set of data? We have already entered several data, is it not? Can you look into your data and tell me what is the result that we should get? For this query, what is the result that we should get? Then we'll let us see whether we are able to do that particular query or not. List the details of all the students who are studying in second semester MCA. Let me see what do we have in student. Select star from student. Can you tell me who are the students who are studying in second semester MCA? What is the result that you should get? At least can you tell me the USN number or the name of those students looking into your data? Look into your data and tell me.
Using where clause, semicolons to.
Yes. See, I'm Darshan, I'm not asking you what should be your query. I'm asking you what should be the result. Look into the data table. We have entered data. You know, if you look into the table, you will know who are all the students who are studying in second semester MCA.
Yes, ma'am.
What is the result that we should get for this particular query is what I'm asking. How to write it, I'm not asking.
Avya,
Kavya, Usha and Seema. That is what you should get. Is it right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yeah. Ma'am.
Yes, these are the students who are studying in second semester MC. Now, these are the details that I should get. All right. So, let us see how we can write it. Now, listen to me very carefully. What they have asked in the query, list the details of students who are all studying in second semester MC. What you should display? You should display the details of the students, right? Now, what you should keep in mind always is, whatever you write after this select, okay, means whatever you want to display as part of the result, that should come immediately after the select. Am I making it clear? Whatever you want to display as part of your result, that should be given here immediately after the select. What they have asked, list the details of the students. So what should you display? You should display the details of the students who are studying in second semester MCA. That's okay. But what you should display? You should display the details of the student. So that details of your students should come immediately after your select. Okay. Details of the student means what? Probably I have to display USN, I have to display name, I have to display address, semester, and the branch name. Let me display everything that is there as part of the student. Okay, what do we have? We have USN, we have name, we have address, we have semester, we have branch. Branch name also I can display. Okay, so these are the things that I have to display. So I will put down all that in this case after the select. Did you get me right? Whatever you want to display as part of your result should come immediately after the select statement. Am I clear? So what should we display here? Details of the students. So when I say details of the student, USN is a detail of the student, name is this detail, address is the detail. That's all is required. But since they have asked semester and branch, we'll put that also so that it's very clear in the query result itself that we are displaying only second semester MCA. So we'll also put down semester, we'll also put down branch name. All right. Now, select s.usn. Now here s means, tell me one thing. Let me come back. I'm going to display the student's USN. I will tell you what it is. S dot name. I'm going to display the address. I'm going to display the semester, which has to be two second semester for all the record. Let it be there so that it becomes more clear or it becomes easy for the user to know that we have displayed only second semester MC. Now, this S dot USN, S dot name, S dot address is all this S. Is nothing but what you call as alias name for the table. Alias name means it's a duplicate name for the table. Now, why do I require this duplicate name? Means I have to tell the Oracle from which table this USN has to be retrieved. It has to be retrieved from the student table, not from some other table also. USN may be there. It may be there in, what other tables do we have? It may be there in book table. It may be there in branch table. Somewhere there it may be there. So I don't want from there and all. I want to tell the Oracle from where you have to get this particular USN. I can write student.usn. The table name itself I can write, but that will become very laborious. That means it is too much to every time type the student, branch name, branch, all these things. So we give a duplicate name. Now, to do this particular query, what are the tables we have to access? Can you tell me?
Branch name you want to access. Branch table.
Yeah, only branch table?
No, you also have to access the student.
Have to access both the student table as well as the branch table. So whatever table you have to access, you have to write after the from clause. From student, yes. That means yes is nothing but we are an alias name for student. Branch B. So here I have given B dot branch name. So that the branch name has to be taken from the branch table. Branch table is also called as B. That is why I have given B dot branch name. What is the condition that I have to check? Now, how are you relating this branch and student? Both are related using the branch ID. Okay, both are related using branch ID. So I should always check S dot branch ID should be equal to B dot branch ID. Okay, because only if it is existing, I'm taking only those. And what is the other condition that I have to check? Branch name should be MCA, because we are interested only in MCA students. And semester comes in your student table. So S dot semester should be equal to 2. What did we do here? What is that I want to display is what I have put here. I want to display the details of the students. Please understand the query. Don't just copy it or don't just do it mechanically, please. So s.usn, I want to retrieve usn from the student table, name from the student table, address from the student table, semester from the student table. Branch name, I want it from the branch table. That is why I have given alias name. You can also write select student.usn, student.name, student.address, student.sem, branch.branchname. That is also perfectly right. But it becomes too much for us to type, so we give an alias name, make it a shortcut. That's all. Then, what are the tables that you are accessing? We have to access student table because we need student details. And I should also access branch table, because only from branch table I get to know how many are in MCA department, correct? Now, how do I find that out? How do I link this? How is student and branch linked? They are linked using branch ID as a variable, as an attribute. So S dot branch ID should be equal to B dot branch ID. And next, what is the condition? B dot branch name should be MCA. S dot semester should be 2. These are the conditions that we have to do. Let me see. All right, Kavya, Usha, and Seema. This is where the details that we wanted. So we have got it. Any doubts in this query, please ask me right away. If you are done, put it in the chat box. If you are not done, if you have errors, if you are having some doubts, please ask me. If you have understood, please understand it and do it. Don't just mechanically do, please. Because going further, you may have to write lot of queries. Unless you have got the concepts right, it becomes very difficult. Have your data in front of you all the time, whatever you have written. I want this kind of reply in the chat box from all of you. Very few are replying actually. Because there's no other way I will get to know that you all have done it. Whatever you are trying to display, put it immediately after the select. That will come as part of your result. And whenever you want to bring the result of that query, first you look into the table and find out what should be your answer. First you analyze that. Do I have some records which is going to match this particular query? Do I have some students who are studying in second semester MCA? First find out that part. So once you find that part, and then you start writing the query, so you know when you get the result, again you get to know that you've done it right. I'm giving enough time before going into the second query because I want all of you to do it. They have asked us to list the details of students. That's why we have given details of students, means all that students' details has to come. So USN is a detail, name is a detail, address is a detail. That is enough actually up to there. But we are also putting semester and branch name because they have asked us who are the students who are studying in second semester in CA. So let us put semester and branch also so that it becomes clear for the examiner or for the user that we have displayed only second semester MCA students. That's all. Otherwise, students details means USN name and address is more than enough. Okay. All right. Shall we proceed to the second query? Those who are not able to do for any whatever reason at your end, well, I do not know. Please at least note down later on. Try and finish it. Maybe somebody said they get the access to the laptop only in the evening and all that stuff. So anyway, so such people at least make a note down all these things and then try it. And if you have any doubts, please ask me right away. I'm telling this repeatedly, but I don't hear from you at all. Okay, the next query is, let's go to the second one. List the students who have not borrowed any books. Can you look into your data and tell me which are those students who have not borrowed? Do we have any students who have not borrowed any books at all? Can you look into your data and tell me who it could be?
Ganesh, ma'am.
Tell me the USN.
USN 6 and 7, ma'am.
6 and 7. What about others? Hema is telling it is 6 and 7. Anybody else? Is she right or wrong, or do you find any other student?
It's correct, ma'am.
Okay. So, students 6 and 7. Do you all agree it is 6 and 7? Others?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So students 6 and 7 are the students who have not borrowed any books. How do we get in that particular query now? Let us try. Now, let me show you a simple, I'm not going to write the full query here. I'll just show it part by part. Okay. Now, these are the, when I say select USN from student. Okay. These are all the USN that we have. These are all the students, right? So students are S1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7 students in the class. Okay. So these are all our students. Now, let me also try to show you select USN from borrow. Borrow table gives you what? Details of the students who have borrowed books. So these are all the students who have borrowed books. Or maybe I can put it as borrowed books. It is showing same S1 twice, thrice, because three times they have taken books. That's why it shows like that. I can make it unique. I told you this. We make use of the keyword distinct. Suppose you want the unique or to remove the duplicates. Okay, I will remove these duplicates because I am not bothered right now. I am not bothered to know how many books each student has taken and all, whether they are borrowed or not. That's all I want to know. So who are the students who have borrowed? These are all the students who have borrowed books. From the borrow table, I can find out who are the students who have borrowed. So, let me write this again. Select USN from student. Okay, now it's clear. See, these are our students. Who are our students? S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6 and S7 are our total students, total number of students. Among these 7 students, these are all students, I'm sorry. These are all students who have borrowed books, S1, S2, S3, S4, S5. So like this, if I do, I'll get to know who have not borrowed. Who are not borrowed? S6 and S7, right? Now, how can I get that? Now in DMS also, we learned a little about set theory, is it not? When we learned set, we looked into some operations of set. In that, we came across this minus operation. A minus B means what?
Elements of A which are not in elements in B.
Exactly. Elements which are in A but not in B. Correct? That is your A minus B. Can we use something like that here? We want to know, we have the list of students, right? We have the list of students. We have the list of students who are borrowed, who have borrowed. So I want the list of students who have not borrowed. Simple. So this minus that, that means the list of students minus the list of students who have borrowed will give me the list of students who have not borrowed. Are you understanding that? We are simply using, going to use the minus operation. So if I try to combine these two query, let me say select USN from student. This is going to give me the list of all my students in the class. Okay, minus, I'm using this my A minus B, that's all. Nothing else I'm doing. Select distinct I will use, because right now I want to remove the duplicates. Distinct USN from borrow. Okay, they A minus B. So set of students minus the set of students who have borrowed books will give me the set of students who have not borrowed the books. See what we are getting? We are getting 6 and 7. Hold on. This is not our final query. We have to list the students. So probably I can try to write. I want the details of this. This is query is absolutely correct. It's perfectly correct. No mistakes. Okay. Now, I want to make it a little more detailed. I want to give the details of that student. List the students. Let me, I want to list the USN. I want to list the name and name also. Let us say. So I will go for, let us say, select USN, comma, name. I get these details from the student where USN in, observe my query, where USN in, this whole query, I will put it inside. It becomes a nested query for me. This whole thing, I know what is the result of this, is it not? I know what is the result I'm going to get for this minus 6 and 7. I know it. I'll put this inside this one. Okay. Then I close this bracket. That's all. Select USN comma name from student where USN in. That means if I execute this part of the query, which is a USN I'm getting? 6 and 7. For that 6 and 7, I want to display the USN and name. Okay, it's not ended properly. What mistake I did?
Double time ended, ma'am.
Ah, that's what. Right? So see here, USN and name I have displayed. Suppose I want to display everything of that students. Select, I can also give star from student where USN in. Let me copy this. See, these are the students who have not borrowed any books. So this becomes your final query. Simply minus select USN from student minus select distinct USN from borrower is absolutely fine. There is nothing wrong in that query. We are only making the query little more descriptive. That's all. We are making the answer little more descriptive. Instead of simply displaying only the USN, we are also displaying the name of that student, complete details of that student. What we are using here is just the minus operation. That's all. We can make use of minus operations in the query. We have the entire set of students. So that we are getting from select USN from student. That gives me the list of all the students. Then I can get the list of all the students who have borrowed books. That I get it from borrow. But I want the list of students who have not borrowed the books. So this minus that I will get. That means list of the complete students minus the list of students who have borrowed will give me the list of students who have not borrowed. Okay. And then for this, once I get that answer, I will put this whole thing as a nested query or as a inner query. One outer query I'll put for this, which is nothing but select star from student where USN in. where USN in means whatever USN I'm going to get for this as a result. For that USN alone, give me all the details. Give me the star means give me all the details. That's how we get this particular result. Any doubts? Do you have any doubts or any queries in this? Always try your queries part by part. Don't jump into writing the whole query. What did I do first? I didn't write the whole query at all first. Is it not? First, I found out who are all the students we have. Then we found out who are all the students who have borrowed. Then we found out, can we find the students who have not borrowed? We got just the USN, yes. Then we wrote an outer query for that. Then fourth step, we wrote the final query we wrote. That's how you should write it. Don't jump into or barge into writing the whole query in one shot. Not required. Your understanding is more important. Any doubts, anyone in this? If you're done and if you're getting it, I don't want to keep repeating. Please keep putting in the chat box. Or if you have doubts, also put it there. I'm seeing that also. So no issues. Any doubts, anyone? No doubts at all, for you all.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah, Lutok.
Ma'am, for ma'am, can you explain select distinct, the keyword distinct?
See, distinct is one which is going to eliminate your duplicate values. Okay, if I don't use distinct, see my screen, select, if I give select USN from borrow, I am displaying whatever USN is there from the borrow table. What do I get? Yes, 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 2, 2, 4, 5. 9 rows I am getting. That means students have borrowed 9 books. Same student, S1 has borrowed 3 books, S3 has borrowed 2 books, S2 has borrowed 2 books, and 4 and 5 have borrowed each of them one book. But here in this case, I am not in this particular query. I am not interested to know how many books each one has borrowed. I don't want the details, whether that student has borrowed or not. That's all I want to know. So I will remove the duplicates from this. If I want to eliminate the duplicates, then I give it as select distinct USN from borrow. See what's happening. S1 is appearing only once. S3 is appearing only once. Like that, all the students who have borrowed, everything that is will appear once. That means these students have borrowed books. That's all information I want as of now for this query. I am not interested to know how many books each one has brought. That will come later, maybe, if they have asked. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Any other doubts, anyone?
What if we reverse the tables between minus?
What if you remove the, what do you want to remove?
Reverse, ma'am, the minus operation, ma'am.
Minus select operation, okay.
What if we reverse both the table, ma'am?
How does minus work? What do you want to know? You want to know how many students have not borrowed the books, is it not?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. But
what if we reverse the A minus B, we'll get the students who have borrowed, ma'am. If we reverse both the table, select distinct from borrow and minus select USN from student.
Okay, what you will get?
That's what, ma'am. Select I.
Yeah, you try and see. But what we want is,
yeah,
what do we want here? We have the entire set of students are there. 50 students are there, let us say, or let me take the same example, 7 students we have. In that 7, I want to know how many are not borrowed. Correct? No.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So if you go into the borrow table, what do you get to know from there? You get to know how many have borrowed only. You don't get to know how many have not borrowed, is it not? Yes. So we get to know how many have borrowed. So we found out from our data that 6 and 7 USN have not borrowed. By looking at the data, we could get that. So how to arrive at that 6 and 7? So the whole lot of students minus the students who have borrowed, separate them out. Then I get the students who have not borrowed. So that is A minus B. If you do the reverse, it makes no sense, at least as far as this query is concerned. No.
Not related to this query, apart outside the query.
Let you try and see what's happening. You will get, I don't think so, because everything is there in B minus A means everything is, that is something that is there in B and not in A is what will get displayed. That such records or no records will be found. If you are doing
row selected.
That's all. Because everything is there in A, no?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ma'am, without the distinct keyword, we get the same result, right? Output.
See, I gave distinct just to know whether I want to remove the duplicates and see. That's all. Because I'm interested to know how many are borrowed. Why I should take 3 times of 1, 2 times of 3, that is not required to me, no?
Yes, I'm correct.
Yeah. Yeah, any other doubts?
Ma'am.
Yeah, Lavanya.
Ma'am, please explain that order by command, ma'am.
Order by is a command or is a keyword that is used for sorting any table, okay, based on a particular key. If you want to sort something, then you have to use order by. Now, suppose I say order by select star from book, order by what key I want, by which attribute, as per which attribute I want to order it, I want to order it by book name. So I will give it as book name. If I leave it, just order by should be there whenever you want to sort. Whenever you want to sort anything in the table, you have to use order by. Now, if you leave it at this, by default, it will sort it by ascending order. See, it will sort by ascending order. All the book names are sorted by ascending order. You don't have to specify anything specifically when you want to sort in ascending order. But when you want to sort it in descending order, then you should give this keyword DESC. Then you will get it in descending order.
Ma'am, actually I'm getting data structure as fourth value, ma'am.
What is your first value then?
OS only, ma'am. Second one DE I got. Third DBMS and fourth data structure.
Even I got same as Lavanya, ma'am.
Hey, ma'am.
Ma'am, the caps variation, ma'am. That's smaller,
correct. Mine is wrong actually here, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Here it is wrong, there it was right.
Ma'am, there also like this only we got, ma'am.
Ma'am, descending and the matlab caps in the barute, small caps in the barute, ascending and the big caps in the barute.
ನಿಮ್ಗೆಲ್ಲ ಬಂತ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ
ಬಂದಿದೆ
ಲಾವಣ್ಯ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಇಟ್ ರೈಟ್
ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ಎಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ದೆನ್ ಡೋಂಟ್ ವರಿ ಲೀವ್ ಓಕೆ ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಡ್ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಕ್ವೆಶ್ಚನ್ಸ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಶದಬ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೇ
ನೋ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಆಲ್ ರೈಟ್ Okay, let us go to the next one. Select the USN student name, branch name, book name, author name, books borrowed, date. We have to display these many things. So they have themselves told what all has to be displayed. So all that I told you, all that has to be displayed has to come immediately after the select. Okay. Borrow name of second semester MCA students who borrowed books. Can you look into your data and tell what data you should get as result for this? All the second semester students who have borrowed books, you have to display their details. Who are the second semester students who have borrowed books? Can you tell me from your data?
USN 1 and 4, ma'am.
Okay. What about others? Are you finding the same answer or is it different? Who are the students? What result you should be getting? Look into your table and tell me. Look into your data and tell me, please. First, you should analyze by looking into your data what should be the answer for this. Then start writing the query accordingly. So USN 1 and 4 are the students, are the second semester MCA students who have borrowed books. All right. Now, the next question for you all is, can you tell me what are the tables that you should be accessing in order to give the result of this query? Which are the tables that you have to access? Can you tell me that?
Student table. Borrow table and branch second sem MCA
student to borrow branch saka
book and
ma'am, from student table and borrow table we can get done.
Now what are all the tables that you should access in order to give the result of this query is what I'm asking you.
Ma'am, borrow table and student table
enough?
Yes ma'am.
Then how will you display author name? How will you display book name? How will you display branch name? That is all not there in book table, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Which are the tables that you will have to access to do this query?
All, ma'am.
You have to take student table. We have to take... Since they have asked branch name, we have to display. Branch name is available only in branch table. So I have to access branch table also. Book name they have asked. So book name is there in this table. Which table it is there? Book name is in book table. So book table also I have to take. Author name they have asked. So author table also I should take. Borrow date they have asked. Borrow date is there only in borrow table. So borrow table also I should take. So all these tables I have to consider in order to write this query. And whichever two tables are connected, how they are connected, they are all connected based on one particular attribute. For example, book and student. Let us say borrow and student. Borrow and student, how they are related by USN. So we have to check the USN. You have to do like that. Let me check once how we have written book and student. They are all related by, okay. Okay, let me try. So, look at the question. What did I tell you? Whatever you have to display should come immediately after the select statement. Correct? What you have to display, they have clearly given. So, let me put on that. Always take the alias name. So, for USN, I have to display. They have asked for student name. These two I will be taking from student table. At USN and name is available in the student table. Okay. Next, I have to display branch name. Branch name, I will get it from branch table. BR dot branch name means BR is my branch table. BR is an alias name for the branch. Okay. Next, I have to display book name. I'll take it as B is nothing but alias name for book. BR is alias name for branch. Right. Next, I have to display author name. Author name is in author table. So let me take A dot author name. A is alias name for author table. Then I have to take borrowed date also I should display. Books borrowed date. So borrowed date is in borrow table. So I will call it as BO. Sorry. we borrowed it. All right. So these are the things that I have to display. So as I told you, whatever you want to display, put it immediately after the select statement. Next. Next, from what you have to write down all the tables that you have to access in order to give the result for this query. What are the tables that we have to access? I have to access student. Student, I'm calling it as yes. That's an alias name. Next, book. Book, I'm calling it as B. You can put it in any order, no problem. Okay. Then I'm also using author A. I'm also using borrow, I call it as BO. I'm also using branch, I call it as BR. Is this clear? Whatever tables you want to access, write it followed by the from clause along with the alias name. Where? Now comes your conditions. Now, however this tables are related, those particular attributes you will always have to check before you write the final condition. For example, s.usn should be equal to your borrow.usn, because borrow table and student table are related like that. And your branch ID you should check. So student.branchid should be equal to, in the branch you have branch ID, that branch ID. And book and borrow, how they are related? They are related using book ID. And author and book, how they are related? Author ID. You have to check all these conditions. And then what they have asked, second semester students. So s.sem should be 2 and branch name, br.branchname should be MCA. Right? So what is that you want to display? Give it immediately after select. This much I have to display. This they have given off. So I don't have any changes there. So I will write it like that. Only thing is I have used the alias name from which table I have to retrieve each of these attributes. Then what are the tables I'm accessing? These are all the tables that I'm accessing. How each of these tables are related? Student and borrow. How are they related? They are related using USN. So I have to check that condition. Student and branch, how they are related? They are related using branch ID. So I have to check that. Book and author, book and borrow, how they are related? Using book ID. So I have to check that. Author and book, how they are related? Using author ID. I have to check that also. All possible connections I have to check. Finally, what they have given? We have to find out students who are in second semester MCA. So I have to check s.sem is 2 and branch name should be MCA. I got some error. What happened
here? Yeah, got branch name.
No. Mine is, the error is here, no. BR dot branch name I have given correctly only. Error is not in that point. Borrow date mein kahin error aa raha hai.
Ma'am, I guess borrow date should be means.
I think I have given it differently, maybe.
W-E-D.
Let me check.
W-E-D, the spelling.
This one you gave borrowed date.
Ma'am, it's bar.
Yeah. That is why I have gone wrong. Borrowed date it is. Borrowed. All right. Where else is borrowed date comes? That's all, huh? Anywhere else? Can I copy it? Nowhere else is borrowed date is there. Right, let me see now. Very good. See there? S1 and S4. That's what you all told me. Hema told me S1 and S4. So we have got S1 and S4. All this we have displayed. What we should display? USN, we should display name, we should display branch name, we should display which book they have borrowed, what is the author name, and what is the borrowed date. Right, so these are the two students who are belonging to second semester MCA and they have borrowed the books. Any doubts, please ask me right away. And if you are done, put it there. Keep doing 1 minute, I will just. Yeah, have you all done? Any errors, anyone? Or any doubts? Yes, Sugandhini, any doubt?
No, ma'am.
Right. If you are not getting or you haven't followed, any doubts, please ask me. Else I cannot get to know unless you tell me. Okay, most of you, if you are finished, let's move to the next one. I'm giving some time for all of you to complete it. Don't make any mistakes and see like borrowed date. I gave something else I had given in the table. Keep your description always in front of you. Describe the table and see what you are given. Accordingly, give your variables. So that way you won't go wrong. Okay. Have you all done? I'm waiting for your answers here in the chat box. Most of you should do it. Only then I will proceed. Manoj, are you doing or not? Manoj? Mohit, you're doing? Mohit, are you there? No reply at all. Many of them don't reply when I take your name. No. Pawan, are you doing? Why, Akrut, why you are not doing it? Are you getting the results or not, Akrut? What is this, Banuprakash? Okay, Akrut, no problem. Okay, let's move to the next one, shall we? Okay. I'm giving you all enough time, assuming that you're all doing it, okay? It is easy for me to rush through, but I don't want to do that. Because since we are learning it remotely, so let's do it in the given time space, no problem. Let's move to the next one. Look at the next query, the fourth one. Display the number of books written by each author. So which means every author, how many books he has written. That is what we have to find out. Can you look into your data and tell me what should be the answer for this? Author A1, how many books he has written? Look into your data. Please try to analyze and tell me. How many books are written by each author? How many books they have written? That is what we have to find out. So we have to find out, our answer should be like, how many books A1 has written? How many books B, A2 has written? A3 has written? A4, A5. We have 5 authors, correct? So each of these authors, how many books they have written? That is what we have to find out. Can you look into your data and tell me what should be the answer for this? Answer me. I want answers. A1, how many? Author A1, how many books he has written?
One, ma'am.
One book, ma'am.
A2 has one written book, 2.
Okay. Yeah.
A3 has written A3. 2.
Okay.
A4, 1. A5, 1.
Yeah. A1 is 1.
A5, 1.
Yes, very good. A1 is 1, A2 is 2, A3 is 2, A4 is 1, A5 has he written? Yeah, he has written 1. So that is the answer that we should get. Correct? So display the number of books written by each author. So what should you display? You should display the author followed by, you should display the count of books. Correct? So I can write select A dot author ID, A1. A1 followed by what I want, how many books he has written. So what I will use is, I'll use a function called as count. So in the last lab, we saw these are all basic numerical functions. Count is a function which will count the number of records. Okay. So what do you want to count? You want to count the books. Correct? So I will take B dot book ID. These are the two things that I want to display. Corresponding to every author, what is the number of books that person has written? So I will count the number of books. Now, can you tell me which are the tables that we have to access in order to do this result? Which are the tables that we have to access now?
Book and author.
Book table and author table.
Very good. Book and author table. These are the only two tables that are sufficient for us. So from, I will take book B, author is my table A. How these two are related? These two tables are connected using author ID, correct? So I will give where B dot author ID is equal to A dot author ID. If I stop my query here, what will happen? Let us see. Let us just see, okay? See? It shows it is not a group function. That means whenever you are using some function like this count, you are trying to count. So there should always be a function called as group by. That means you are trying to give based on the author. So you are grouping it. All books of A1, you are grouping. All books of A2, you are grouping. And then you are trying to find out what is the count. That's why we should give group by, and whatever you are going to give after, immediately after select, immediately after select, that should come immediately after the group ID, otherwise there will be error. Author group by author ID means what? You are trying to group it, it with respect to what? Author. Because with respect to author only, I am trying to count the number of books. So this count is getting grouped with respect to your author. A1 three books means, let us say, how it will get that count? See here, A1 is 1, A2 is 2, A3 is 2, A4 is 1, A5 is 1. Any doubts? For every author, I am counting it. That's why I give it as group by. If I am doing something for every author, then I have to always give group by. For every author, I am counting how many books they have written. Any doubts, errors, questions? Anyone getting errors or getting stuck with some errors, please let me know. I am waiting only for you all to finish. I am repeating it again and again. You are trying to, based on, while you do, I'll again explain it. For every author, I want to display the number of books that he has written. Okay. That is why we have written A dot author ID, comma, count of book ID. Now, what are the tables that we access? Book B and author A. These are the tables. So how these two tables are related? These two tables get connected by author ID. So I got to check this. Then I have to write, since we have this particular condition, that is author ID and count of book. This count of book ID should be done for every author. For every author, I have to count the number of books. That is the reason I have to use this group by function. Please understand what is group by. Again, we'll come back to group by in theory classes, but since we have to understand now because we are using it. Group by means, if you are doing it for every particular instance, then you have to use a group by function. And whatever you are giving immediately after the select should also, or in other words, whatever you are trying to give after group by should also be there immediately after your select. Otherwise, it will show error to you. So, for every author, I am counting the number of books. For A1, how many books? For A2, how many books? For A3, how many? A4, how many? A5, how many? So, like this, for every author, I am counting. So, that is the reason I have written. For every author means you should always use something that you are doing for every author, which means you have to use group by. Yeah, any doubt, anyone?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, if we want to print the books based on the author, and love every book written by which author, how that we can do that?
Sorry, you want to print whether every book written by that author?
Which author? From the book table, we will take the book and each book is written by which author. Then what command we have to give, ma'am?
Same thing. The book table itself will give you that information, no? Which book is written by which author?
Yes, ma'am.
And for that, we have to use author table and book table, I think.
Correct, yes. Author table and book table. Let us reserve this query towards the end, Raman. Let me finish. I will be giving some extra queries. This also I will be taking as an extra query. Let's finish with the lab exercise and we'll take up the extra queries. Okay?
Okay. Okay.
So what is, I'll just note down this query so that we'll come back to that. You want to display the book name of, come again?
I want to display the book name written by the specific authors. Which book is written by which author?
Which book is written by which author? Okay, fine. We'll take it up in the end. Right. I have a couple of extra queries to be done in the end. So along with that, I'll take this. First, I'll finish with the lab exercise. Shall we move to the next one? Right. So what
next
is
one?
Yeah, good. Next one is what? Display the fifth one. We are in the fifth query. Display the student details who borrowed more than two books. Can you look into the book, data and tell me who are the students who have borrowed more than two books? More than two, not even equal to two. We want, are there any students who have borrowed more than two in our data? Look into your data and tell me from where do you get this information and tell me who are the...
USN 01, ma'am.
01, has he borrowed more than two?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, yes. S1 is the only student?
Yes, ma'am. More than two.
Yes, ma'am.
How many?
Three, ma'am.
Okay.
Three ma'am. Books, ma'am.
Right, right. So we have to bring that result now. How can we bring this? How do you go about doing this? Tell me. Tell me, ma'am. Tell me, Ganaka.
Count.
Exactly. For every student who has borrowed the books, we have to count how many books he has borrowed. Correct? Now, once you get that count of every student, then we will try to find out only those students who have more than two as the count. Correct? So that's how we should go about writing this query. First, we have to do what? For every student, you have to count how many books they have borrowed. Now, which are the tables you are going to access for this query?
Student and borrow.
Student and
borrow and book.
Borrow and book. Student, borrow, book. All the three are required. Right? Because you have to find out borrow how many books has been borrowed. Book and borrow means these two are related. So book and borrow also we need student details. So we have to access student also. So student, borrow, book. These are the three tables that you will have to access. Right. So let us try writing this query. Select for every, first see here what I am doing. For every student, I have to first count. What should I count? Can anyone tell me?
USN.
Hey. How can you count?
Book ID.
Book.
Yeah, you have to count the books that he has borrowed. Is it not? So from which table you have to count this?
Borrow table.
Very good. So count BO dot book ID I'm giving. BO is my borrow. Okay. So what does this mean now? For every student, look at that. I am going to count the number of books borrowed, which I am getting from the count of BO dot book ID is nothing but my borrow table. From borrow table, say I am taking the number of books. Okay. What are the tables I'll access? Student is my yes. I have to access, I have to access borrow, which I am taking it as BO. I also need book table here, which I take it as BK. Okay. See this alias name, you can take anything, no issues there. Book can be B, borrow can be BR, whatever you want, you can take. Don't worry about that. Where? Now, however, these three tables are related, that condition first we have to check. How is a student and borrow related? They are related through the USN. So I have to give USN, s.usn should be equal to bo.usn and borrow and book, how they are related? Borrow and book are related in terms of
book ID.
Book ID, very good. BO dot, so I will write it as BO dot book ID is equal to BK dot book. Okay, BK dot book ID. Now, if for every student, I have to count. Okay, so what did we do in the last query? For every student, for every author, whenever you have this every, you have to make use of what function?
Group function.
Group. Very good. So you have to use group by. What should come immediately after group by?
S.usn.
Very good. Whatever you are giving immediately after your group by should also be there immediately as after your select. Let me stop this query here only and then show you what result we are going to get. What is happening here? We are counting the number of books by all the students. For every student, we are counting the number of books. So S1 is 3, S2 is 2, S3 is 2, S4 is 1, S5 is 1. But we don't want this. What do we want? We want only those who have borrowed more than 2. So if you look into this table result, we identify that only S1 has more than 2, that is 3. So we have to get that 3 now. We don't want this. So what I will do is, out of this group by, on, see, for every student, I have counted the number of books that he has borrowed. On this result, I will put a condition. That I am doing using this having clause. Whatever data result now I have got already, I have already, for every student, I have already counted. But I don't want everything. So I will put a condition on this particular result, or I'll put a filter now. What is my filter? I want the count wherever the count is going to be more than 2. That is my filter. That is my condition. How do I write this? Count of BO dot book ID. That is count. We have already counted, is it not? Where count is going to be greater than. What did we do? For every student, please understand, copying it and typing there and getting the result is not the big deal here. For every student, we counted the number of books. How do you say every student? Because we made use of group by. That result we have shown here. For every student, we counted the number of books and we saw how many books are obtained. But what are we supposed to find out? We are supposed to find out only those students who have borrowed more than 2. Right. So on this result, I am going to put a condition or I am going to put a filter. I don't want all this. I want only those wherein this data is going to be more than 2. How do I specify that? I specify that using this having clause, where having means having count of this greater than 2. See there, we got S101 where it is 3. Whenever you are not using group by, listen to me carefully. Whenever you are not using group by, you cannot use having. But you can use group by without having, as we have done in the previous query. We have used group by, but we have not used any having there. But you cannot use having if you have not used group by. Only when you use group by, you can use having. But you can use group by when you are not using having also, right? Any doubts? Any questions, any doubts, any errors? I don't know. You should tell me.
Ma'am, they asked the details of the students who borrowed more than 2 books. We are just showing the student USN and the number of books he borrowed.
Yeah, that's okay. As long as we are showing those details, if you want, you can put an outer query also. No problem. You can do that. Try doing it like we did in the previous query and show me the result. All of you try that. Put an outer query to display all the details of all that student and then put this inside. and tell me if you are getting it. You should start trying like that. But whenever we use a group function, it's okay if we leave it at this because it will become more complicated, I feel, that query. Student USN details are enough. Try, but if you're getting it. Have you all done? Any errors? Have you all done this? Can I have some answers, please? Have you done nothing in the chat box? Nothing from you all? I want to hear from you all, please. Are you all doing it? Okay. Anybody getting errors? If your data entry has gone wrong somewhere, then you may not get these results. If you're done as I have given, then yes, you will get it. Raman, you are able to connect and then do it, is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine, good. Shall we proceed or you need some more time on this query? All of you. Okay, we shall move on to the next one. What is the next one? The sixth query we are in now. Display the student details who borrowed books of more than one author. Who are those who have borrowed books of more than one author? Can you all look into your tables and tell me the result for this? What you should be getting your answer as? Who are the students who borrowed books of more than one author? So obviously they all should have borrowed more than one book, is it not? That only they can borrow more than one author also. Otherwise it is not possible. So I think your answer should be somewhere between 3 to 2 only. They are the ones who have borrowed more than one book. Have they borrowed books of more than one author also, or same author means we have to drop it. If it is more than one author, if they have borrowed, then your answer will be that only. What is the result from your data? Any answers? Look into your data and tell me. I hope you are all looking into it. More than one author means obviously they should have borrowed more than one book. Only then we can.
Kavya.
Okay, what is the USN?
One.
One. Only one student? See, these S1, S2, S3 are all, they have borrowed 3, 2, 2. So among these three, you have to check if they have borrowed. Authors also different, more than one author. If they are, then we this will be your answer. 4 and 5 will not come into the picture at all because they have just borrowed only one book. So we want books of more than one author. When books are only one, then that makes no sense, no? More than one author means you should also have more than one book, first of all. Yeah, anyway, why you are not able to find out the answer, anyone?
S1, 2, and 3, ma'am.
All the three are borrowed more than one book. All the three are borrowed more than one author also?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Lakshmi, why you went wrong then? You have told 1 and 3 only. 1, 2, and 3. Are you able to identify that? Okay. So let us see how we can arrive at that. So for every student, what I should count? What should I count?
Borrow book, ma'am. Book ID.
No, you are borrowing book, but you should count the, for every student, you should count the number of authors.
Okay.
Yes? Yes, Akhil?
I'm author ID.
Yes, yes. So, for every student USN, I have to count the author ID. What are the tables that I have to access for this query?
Student, book, borrow, and
student, book,
author.
Author. Yeah, borrow, author, everything. We have to do, consider all the four tables. Student, borrow, book, author. All are required. And then let us first check the conditions like related to how they are related. Student.usn is equal to borrow.usn and book ID, I have to check between book and borrow. And author ID, I have to check between author and book. Okay. Now for every student, I am trying to count the author ID. So let me stop at this point, this query, and then I will show you what is the result that we are going to get. See there. This again shows how many books they have borrowed of different authors. But we don't want all this. What we want only those who have borrowed more than one author. That means this count should be more than one, only that I should retrieve. So what I should use here?
Count
we have already used. What I already counted, I got this result, but I don't want all this, is it not? We want only those who are having more than one author, that is 3, 2, 2, that's all. S1, S2, S3. So what I should now make changes in my query?
I'm having count author ID greater than one.
Very good, very good. I have to put a filter on this group now. I have already counted for every student. I have counted the authors, number of authors. But I don't want everyone. What I want, only wherever the count is more than one, I am interested only in that. So I use a having clause. Having count of author ID greater than 1. See, these are all books which have been borrowed more than one author is there. Whatever you are using immediately after select should also come immediately after your group by. And whatever function, aggregate, this is called as an aggregate function. Whatever aggregate function you are using, that should come immediately after your count. I already told you, you can use group by without having. But you cannot use having without group by. If you are using having clause, group by should be there. What are we doing here? While you do it, I'll explain again. For every student, we are counting the number of authors because from the book borrow we are taking. So how many authors books they have borrowed? For every student means what I should do? I have to use a group by. So when I do that, I get this particular value. I mean, I get this one. 32211, because for every student I have counted, but I am not interested in every student. I want only those who have borrowed books of more than one author. So wherever the count is going to be more than one, I am interested only in that. So I put a filter on this particular group function result. When I put a filter, how do I put? I put it using having count of A dot author ID greater than 1. So then I get this result. Any doubts, questions, errors? If you are done, put it there. Or if you are not able to do, tell me. If you are getting errors, let me know.
I am in this query.
Yeah.
If we use only student table, borrow table, and author table, we cannot get that, ma'am, the result.
Borrow table, student table, and?
And author table.
No, you cannot get. Because you have to check the book written by that author. That you can, that part of it you can check only in your book table. That book also, I mean, that book has to be borrowed again. Book and borrow you have to check. You should also check book and author. That book has to be written by that author. Na? That yes, part ma'am. You have to check. So that's why we are using that.
Yeah, got it.
Yeah. Any doubts, anyone? Any doubts, any errors? Please try at your end. If you are not trying, things will be difficult. Don't just by heart the queries. Don't ever do that. Don't ever do that. You have to learn to write your own queries. That's very, very important. Any questions, any doubts?
Ma'am, one question.
Yeah.
Ma'am, when deriving at this solution to this queries, if we use extra, ma'am, more tables, if we use 3, 4, 5 tables, and we are getting to reaching that to that queries solution, but we can reach that solution from 3 tables, ma'am, it will differ in the execution process. It will differ in the time taken, ma'am.
Yeah. It will differ, but you are, see, always your query should be more optimized. See, you can write a query and get the answer writing a very simple query. You can make it complicated also and still get that same result, right? So how you are trying to do or how you want to write the efficiency, it is within you. And moreover, you should always write a very optimal query. Here in this case, you will not get the result. Are you getting?
No, ma'am. For this, I was not getting. For above one, I was getting.
Above one, na? Which one? Book.
Yes, ma'am. Count. Student taking the book from number of books taken by student. The okay. count I was getting from ma'am only two tables using UASN and book ID and book table. No, sorry, ma'am. Borrow table. So using student and borrow table.
You have not checked for book ID on book ID in borrow and book, is it? You have to check because you have to always identify the corresponding books which have been borrowed, whether the same ID is there like that. You have to check, no, whether that book has been borrowed or not.
Yes, ma'am. I checked that from borrow table. I used student table and then and borrow table.
Student table and borrow table. Again, that book, whether that book is listed in your book table, that is more important to check also. Every time you may not get the right result, sometimes it will go wrong if you don't apply the proper foreign key checking.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. For that, yes, ma'am, it will go wrong.
Yeah. Shall we do the next one? Have all of you done it? Any more questions on this? The seventh one we have already done. The last one is list the details of students who borrowed the books, which are all published by the same publisher. So I want to details of students who borrowed the books, which are published by the same publisher. Okay, here publisher name is not given. We can try to take a specific publisher and try and check our result. Okay, that's how we just do it. So list the details of students. Let us try to list. S.USN. Then I will give S.name. I will also display the book name. I will also display the publisher. What are the tables that are required here? I have to take the student table. Book table is required. They have asked for borrow, so borrow table is also required. Where I'll check all these conditions. Now, after checking this, same publisher, that means I can specify a particular publisher here and then check if I am getting the same result. I will give it as, let us say, TMH, Tata McGraw-Hill, we have given as one publisher. So these are the books which the student, details of students who borrowed the books, which are all published with the same publisher. I can always do this query by changing my publisher also. That is also possible. Suppose I give it as, let us say, Prentice Hall India, or maybe I've given Pearson. So Pearson is taken by that student. So like this, I can change the publisher here. Since they have not mentioned any publisher, same publisher is what we are looking out for. That is why we can give like that. Any doubts in this? You can specify what is the publisher name and then try to execute it. I am displaying the publisher also so that they know, we get to know that we are trying to display all those books which are taken by the same publisher only. So this Harish, he is taking DBMS, which is published by TMH. Electronic, digital electronics also is by TMH only. Thank you. Any doubts, any questions, errors? Put the publisher name. If you have the same student who has taken the two books of the same publisher, try giving that kind of a publisher. That is what I have given. TMH, Tata McGraw-Hill is same publisher. Two books have been taken by the same student. So that is the reason I have given that. Do it and let me know. As I told you, for every exercise, we will be doing some extra queries. We will not stick just to this. We'll also, now the 8 queries we have done, we may take up a couple of more queries on the same exercise so that you get to understand, And in the examination, as I told you, Viva need not be a Viva question. They can, on the exercise that you get, they may ask you to do some extra queries. They may give you some additional queries. And you should be able to do it. That also they will consider as Viva. Generally, DBMS and all, they will do like that only. So that they will check you whether you really know things. Any doubts, any questions have you all done? If you have done, please put it there in the chat box, please. Yes, Raman, any doubts?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
In my table, there are two books published by publishers named TMH. But I am getting only one.
All the three, you have given it in the same way. And have you given it in the query also the same way that you have given it in the table? Have you given it in the same, enter it in the same way in your table? That matters also. See here, look into my screen, please. See, I gave in the query, if you observe, let me just scroll up. See here, in this query of Tata McGraw-Hill, I have given, in the query, I gave it as capital TMH, right? So that's why I have got here two books, two students who have taken books of that particular publisher. But look into my book table. What I have done here, the first one, I have given it in small case. That is why it is not coming. I was wondering I should be getting three books out of TMH. Did you all get or two or three? What did you all get?
Three I got, ma'am.
Yeah, very good. You should have told me, no? Then why I got two? Good. You should get three only. But because I made this mistake while entering, I gave it a small case. And in my query, I'm giving it as a capital TMH. So only two capital TMH are getting retrieved. The others are not getting retrieved. So that matters a lot. Check your query, Raman, the way you have entered your data. That matters a lot.
My both publisher name in small letter TMH.
Then what you gave in query? Small TMH you have given?
Yes, ma'am.
Then it should come, no? I will check later after the lab.
Okay.
Ma'am, alter the first row, like caps.
What, Panaka?
Ma'am, can you just alter the first row of that table in TMH?
You want me to alter that? Huh?
Yes, ma'am. Convert it to caps.
I can use update. Which is that update book? Can you set what is the syntax? I forgot. Is it modify or set?
Set now.
Yeah. Set publisher equal to TMH where book ID is equal to BK1. Right, Kanaka?
Yes, ma'am.
Now let me run that query. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that's fine. All right. Shall we do the next query? This is our completion of what is given in the lab cycle. Okay. As I told you, every exercise, we will be also trying out some extra queries. Now, I want all of you to try the query that Raman asked, which book is written by which author? That you have to display. Let's try that. You should also now start trying your queries. Extra queries, I think you should try. So you have to display which book is written by which author. So let me display book name. I will also display author name. I will take these two what is that, tables, book B and author A, where these two I'm trying to link it by book and author. No, how they are related? Author ID. Okay, Raman, see there. Raman?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. This is a query that you wanted?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Others, please note, we are trying to, these are all extra queries. 8 queries we have done of the lab cycle. We are just trying out a couple of one or two extra queries. So one of them you raised by your own classmate. So I did that first. Select. What he asked for is, how do I display, I want to display which book is written by which author. That is what he asked me. So what do you want to display? We want to display the book name, author name, which book is displayed, written by which author. So I'm trying to display these two details, which are the tables that I have to access, book and author. What I am trying to check is how they are related. They are related by author ID. So A dot author ID is equal to B dot author ID. And then I get to know which book is written by which author. Any doubts and any clarifications that is required on this? Have you all done? Please note down these also. You can put it in your observation and later on in the record. Don't think only those queries you have to do. You have to do the extra queries also. No issues. Something extra you write, nobody will question you. Don't worry about that. Any doubts, any errors, any questions? Or if you have done it and you got it, then I need an answer from your side. Done, Mama. Okay. All right.
Sorry.
No problem. Have you all done? If you all done, I am going to give you one query which you have to try. I will not do. I'll give you 2 minutes time. You have to try and give me the result. Okay, I think all of you got it. Okay, shall we go to the next one? I think many of you have done. Shall we move on to one more extra, one or two extra queries we'll try to work out. And these queries you have to do. You have to try, at least try, start trying. If everything I'll spoon feed you, then what will you learn? I'm putting it in this chat window. Okay, my query is display all the authors of a specific country. That's my query. Try and display this. Display all the authors of a specific country. Do we have more than one author of a country? I should check that first. I don't know if we have. Where do we get authors, country details? Where do we get that? Which table do we get that?
Author.
Author, huh? Okay, let me check. Sub table. Sell it. I think author. Yeah, I think we have some authors from USA. Very good. So I think of a specific country, you should display. What did I say? I should probably give you something tough. Anyway, let me do this. This is a very simple one. Do it. Next, we'll try. Display all the authors of a specific country. Since I have not specified the country, you can in the query specify any country. Whichever country you are specifying, you should get that result. Like we did in the publisher, no? Like that. You can specify the corresponding value in the query itself. I'll give you 2 minutes time. Do it. Select star from author by country equal to USA. USA, did you put it in double quotes, Lakshmi? Does double quote work for you there? Single quote only will work.
Ma'am, both works, ma'am. Single and double quote for strings.
Okay, fine. Some versions of Oracle, there are so many restrictions. I didn't check here. That's why. Did all of you get that? Okay. All right, good. Okay. All right, good. Can do this. Display the books borrowed in 2020. My next question. 2 minutes. So you keep doing, I'll be back in a minute. Are you able to do it? Display the books borrowed in 2020. Anyone got the result? Okay, select star from borrow, where borrow date is between. Did all of you give the same query? Is there any different query given? If your query is different from what Manish has posted, put it on the chat box. Put it on the chat box if you have done. If there is a different query, put the query. Select star from borrow where borrow date. Very good. Very good, Arvind. Because we have used date as a string, that is bearcat 2, we can always use the like predicate and give the percentage, use the percentage wildcard and find it out. That is also a very different way of writing. I was expecting this from someone. Very, very good. Arvind has done. Others? Any other different query apart from these two? Or if you have tried and got the result also, it's okay. You can put in the chat box that you have got it. If you are finished. Good, Lakshmi, good. Both are right, anyways, you can do it that way or this way, anyways. Where borrowed, like, yeah, that is also fine, Darshan. That also is possible, yes. Now 2020, this can be 1920 also, Darshan, but you can't write this now. If somebody has given a date like 1920, then that will be wrong. So what, yes, you can't use percentage 20, that will be wrong. Any other query? Have you all done? Okay, let us try some other query then. Can you do this query? Display the number of students who belong to branch B1. Display the number of students who belong to branch B1. Try this query. See, unless you try queries on your own, you will not learn DBMS. I am very, very sure on that. You have to write down your own queries. So as you go and proceed further, we keep doing like this, you will learn it. So don't worry that you will not learn or it's tough or something like that. It's all easy. You can pick up. Don't worry. But you will have to try. Unless you try, you will not learn. Count of USN from student where branch ID is B1. Select star from student where branch ID is B1. Manish, I asked you the number of students.
Okay, ma'am. Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Select USN count of branch ID from student. Lakshmi, this will, this is not actually required. Number of students belonging to branch, no, B1. So group by is not required there. See, group by will come when you are doing something for every student you want to count. Then you will do that. For every student, we are not going to count the number of branch. Every student belongs only to one branch, no? So that will not come. This query is a little wrong only. Yes. Count of USN from student where branch ID is B1. That's simplest. Yes. Okay, any doubts, anyone? Right. So this finishes your first exercise. Whatever extra queries we have done, you can please write down those queries also in your lab observation, followed by whenever you write your lab record, if and when. Otherwise, as I told you already, maintain your written copy of your observation in whatever form as of now. All these queries and the results that you get should be all written properly. Your create statements of all the tables should be written. For insertion, you can just write one statement and put down the table of data. That will suffice. Don't sit and keep writing 8-9 times of insertion statements. That is not required. Do you get me? If we have 5 tables, creation statement of all the 5 tables you write down. Insertion, of course, we are entering more than one record. I mean, let's say a minimum of 5 records we are entering. I think in every table we have entered here, more than 5 is also there. So in that case, write one insertion statement, just a major insertion statement, and then write the table of data that you have. After that, you have to write down the queries and the corresponding results. In the unruled side, you have to write the ER diagram and the schema diagram whenever you write the record. But otherwise, also now keep everything written. A written copy should be there. First thing that you should write for any exercise is a ER diagram, followed by your schema diagram, followed by create statements, insertion, one insertion statement per table, and then the table of data that you have. For every table, data should be put down. Then write the queries. For every query, what result you got, that also should be written. This much you have to write for every exercise. Okay. Now itself, you keep it ready, written copy, you keep it ready. And the first thing that you have to write is the basic commands. After that, this one. Any doubts, anyone? Answer attendance. After this, after attendance, if anybody has any errors, you can share your screen. I will help you. And later on, if you are trying and if you are getting errors also, you can send the screenshot to me on WhatsApp one-on-one. Don't put it in that group. You come to me on one-on-one. You can share the screenshot with me. I can look into it and let you know what error you have done. Okay. That way I'll be able to help you. If any other means you have, you can let me know. But please get your queries right and do your exercise properly. Because this DBMS is very important. I am always here to help you out. If you keep your doubts to yourself, then how will I know what is happening in your screen? Unless you share your, you have to share your screen. After this, you can share it now, after we finish with the attendance. Or if you are not able to do now, if you are doing it at a later time also, you can ask me whenever you want. You put it on the WhatsApp so that I can reply to you looking at your screen as to what is the error. Right? That is from my side. If you don't do it, then I cannot help you out. Anaga?
Yes, ma'am.
Abhilash?
Yes, ma'am.
Akhil?
Yes, ma'am.
Makrut? Anusha? Arvind?
Present, ma'am.
Arifullah?
Yes, ma'am.
Banakraj?
Present, ma'am.
Vanu?
Yes, ma'am.
Bhargav?
Yes, ma'am.
Rahmatullah?
Present, ma'am.
Chaitra?
Present, ma'am.
Chandana?
Present, ma'am.
Charan?
Yes, ma'am.
Darshan?
Present, ma'am.
Diksha? Dakshaini?
Present, ma'am.
Diksha hasn't come. Ishan? Harshit?
Haan, ma'am.
Harshit? Hema?
Present, ma'am.
Uma?
Yes, ma'am.
Jayant?
Present, ma'am.
Divya?
Yes, ma'am.
Kaushik?
Present, ma'am.
Lakshmi, Lavanya?
Present, ma'am.
Manish? Manoj?
Ma'am, present, ma'am, Manish.
Yeah. Mohit?
Yes, ma'am. I'm
present, ma'am, Manoj.
Okay. Naval?
Present, ma'am.
Navya?
Present, ma'am.
Nikhil?
Present, ma'am.
Panindra? Panindra has not come today. Pavan?
Yes, ma'am.
Pooja?
Present, ma'am.
Purnima?
Present, ma'am.
Raman? Raman?
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi?
Yes, ma'am.
Rupak?
Yes, ma'am.
Sai Kumar?
Present, ma'am.
Sameer?
Present, ma'am.
Santosh?
Present, ma'am.
Chadar?
Present, ma'am.
Karan?
Present, ma'am.
Shashank?
Present, ma'am.
Sheetal?
Present, ma'am.
Shivani?
Present, ma'am.
Soumya?
Present, ma'am.
Purti?
Present, ma'am.
Vishnu?
Present, ma'am.
Sugandhini?
Present, ma'am.
Sushma?
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita B.S.?
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita U.?
Present, ma'am.
Deepta?
Present, ma'am.
Purti?
Present, ma'am.
Harsha? Veena?
Present, ma'am.
Lakshmi is present, Harshit is present, Manoj present, Banu present. Anusha is present, Akrut is present. Okay?
Ma'am, Kishan is also present, ma'am.
Yeah, Kishan I marked too. Panindra is absent, Deeksha is absent. Both are not there. Right? So if now anybody, if anybody has some problem with your execution, you can share your screen. I will help you. Right? Yeah.
I have a different query, ma'am, like for displaying the books in 2020. Shall I present?
Yeah, please.
I have done this query, ma'am. It will show the book name that have been borrowed in year 2020.
Yeah, that is what somebody has posted and then I approved it, no?
Okay.
Somebody, Arvind had done. Yeah, it's right, Banaka.
Okay.
Yeah. Others, if you have any errors at your end and not able to execute something, and if you want to share your screen, you can do it. I can help you out with if you have any errors now. Or if you are going to do it later, as I told you, come on one-to-one on WhatsApp. You can share your screenshots. I'll help you there also. Beyond this, if you are not doing it, I cannot help you. Lakshmi is presenting. Okay. Select USN from student minus distinct USN from borrow. To this command, error is coming, ma'am. I'm using Ubuntu. God, I'm not able to see it at all now, Lakshmi. Okay, let me see what you have done. What error you are getting, Lakshmi? What is your error?
Hello, ma'am. It's showing that write syntax to use near select distinct USN from borrow.
Write syntax. What is error?
One second, ma'am. I'm sharing that exact one.
Yeah.
Is it visible, ma'am?
It's loading one second. Yeah, it is visible. Select star from student minus select distinct USN from borrow. Error is you have an error in your SQL syntax. Check the manual term. Select distinct USN from borrow to line 1. This people are leaving this. No, that message keeps coming on the side. I'm not able to. One second. That's better. Yeah. Select the USN from student minus select the distinct USN from borrow. Okay. Corresponds to your MySQL version for the write syntax to use near select distinct from borrow at line 1. You may have to check what is the syntax in this MySQL. There may be some changes in your syntax, Lakshmi. SQL and MySQL, some small variations are there. Minus, I think, may not be supported in MySQL, I think. That is why it is
actually,
not.
Ma'am, actually, it's showing as minus only. In Google, I have searched about it.
Uh-huh. But why are you using this? Why you have not gone for SQL?
Ma'am, in Ubuntu, there is built-in MySQL. Shashi sir suggested this only, ma'am.
But syntax variations will be there here, Lakshmi.
Yes, ma'am.
SQL, MySQL, I think minus will not support is what I'm thinking.
Okay, ma'am. I'll once check and if I don't get it, I'll come back to you.
Yeah, please. Yeah. I'll also check Mumbai.
Okay. I'm not in can also be used, ma'am, for second query.
Not? What, Manish?
Ma'am, here. Ma'am, I was posted in chat box, ma'am.
Yeah, you can use. Not also you can use. Where USN not in select USN from borrow. That also, yes, you can use that. Try that, Lakshmi. See, the same query, different ways are there to do it. Maybe if you are all coming out with different ways, that's I am very happy about it. I can only teach one syntax, one query. No? Not can be used. No issues. That should work? No. Not also is not showing. No? Mm-hmm. Now there is some error here. Check not in
select. I have tried difference and other two commands also, ma'am. None of they work.
Lakshmi, you are missing that where evasion not in. Select evasion from student where evasion not in.
Okay. Kim?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you, Manish.
Right. Anyone else who has any errors and we want to share the screen and get clarified, can please do. Is there anyone else? It's okay. If there are no more queries, then I think I will wind up this lab. Right? Thank you all. We'll meet again in the next theory class. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.